China by now is the second strongest contributing market to the rest of the world. In general, North American travel is still the number one, but it's only a matter of years that the Chinese traveler will make the lion's share, frankly, of global travel.
The outbound travel market for China is just about 20 years, let's say. And then in these 20 years, maybe we experience the things much faster than the other countries. Let's talk about Europe market. For example, at the first, people will travel like 10 countries within 15 days. Now people are thinking about a mono destination, probably for 10 days. So this is a totally different story.
If we would have come to China 10 years ago, in the luxury travel industry, those were not as meaningful as they are now, because 10 years ago, it was all about luxury is equal with opulence. It's got to be a lot of bling bling and chandeliers and all that. And I think those days are gone now for the Chinese luxury traveler, because they're much more educated. They've been overseas. They've seen a lot of great things in the world. And then they're sort of on the pulse on what's happening in the world. And actually, they want to be ahead now of everywhere else. So you really got to make sure that you're sort of in tune with the times.
For the Chinese travelers, their habits is it's totally different with the European or American market. So they try to find something and then to satisfy the Chinese clients. For example, they will have the Chinese speaking staff, maybe in overseas or in China, to taking care of the Chinese guests.
We treat the hotel as a professional DMC in the local place. So they doing customized a lot of things to us, like the breakfast. They serve some Chinese food for us.
All our website material, collateral, social media is in Chinese, so we can communicate with the Chinese directly. And also what we did is we have invested into trainings in our company in order to educate every single person working with us to understand the Chinese market.
China is a market that evolves every day. Literally, it's easy to fall behind, whether it's in terms of trends or technology. So it's very important for us to have access to this data. Hurun Report, for example, is a very good source of information, but there are many others.
Singaporean Chinese are very different to Hong Kong Chinese, very different to mainland Chinese. Indonesian Chinese are very different as well, so they come with their own cultural variants.
If it's a solo brand, it's not an international brand, come to China market, it's really important for them to know that people are looking for one-stop service. If you are a single hotel, it's really hard for us to convince the clients to purchase this hotel.
The sweet spot really for our customers, our clientele, is really about accessibility, quality of services, as well as, of course, price. So we've got to find that sweet spot amongst these three different circles for the overlap.